डोंट वरी, मोस्ट ऑफ इट इज जीके पार्ट, ओके, विच
या
यू हैव टू स्टडी बाय योर ओन एनीवे, ओके. सो विल डिस्कस दैट कि व्हाट यू हैव टू डू फर्स्ट फॉर द न्यू स्टूडेंट्स स्पेशली, एंड विल डिस्कस फॉर द ओल्ड स्टूडेंट्स आल्सो, ओके. देन इट
थैंक
विल
यू.
बी, कैन यू टेल मी इफ यू ड्रॉ, इफ यू हैव अ हैबिट ऑफ ड्रॉइंग,
सॉरी मैम, आई कांट हियर यू, विल यू
डू यू हैव
रिपीट?
अ हैबिट ऑफ ड्रॉइंग, हाउ हॉबी, सॉरी.
I have actually, but it's not like professional type. I haven't done any classes. I draw in my like own style and own way.
Okay, fine. That's what I wanted to know. If you know, if you do drawing, then we can work with what to do first. Okay, so don't worry about it.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Anusha Rao. Okay, Anusha, now Prajakta and Katha. All three of you, don't worry. Even the others will discuss what you have to do first, which will be beneficial to do first. Okay, don't worry. If you have doubt about this, we'll discuss on that. No problem. Okay, so also if there are any new students, just tell me you are new, okay? It will help me to explain better. Because we start with old students, it feels that they have done this before, so I don't need to explain too much. But if there are new students coming, please tell me, then we can, you know, I'll tell you the background. Now, what they have done in this paper is, they have given architecture plan of a temple and a church in your question paper, and they had given a list of the parts of the church or and temple. Okay, and they had asked which of them are the most important ones, three most important. So what we do, almost every day we've been doing this for a week or so, we take temples or churches architecture plans and we discuss. Okay, so this is one of the one of such classes. This is the Kandariya Mahadev Temple. It's in Khajurao. Okay, it's Khajurao is a group of monuments. Okay, it's in MP, Chhatarpur. Okay, Kandariya Temple is one of the largest temples. Okay, this is how it looks from the front. Okay, very dramatic. This is from looks back. Shitab joined 1 week back. Sankit joined 15 days. Okay. Don't worry, I'll ask every day if anybody is new. Okay. Then we can properly discuss. Okay, so Kandariya Mahadev Temple. It is the largest and most ornate Hindu temple in the medieval temple group found in Khajurao in Madhya Pradesh, India. Okay, ornate means
decorative.
Yes, very decorative. If you see, just see the image itself, you see how much it has been covered with sculptures, carvings. Okay, Khajurao ka speciality is that mostly. Okay, it is considered one of the best examples of temples preserved from the medieval period in India. Kandariya Temple occupies an area of about 6,500 square feet. Now, the numbers and the statistics, no need to by heart them. Okay, I don't think they'll ask because there are many temples and many statistics like that. Just read them. Okay, 6,500 square feet area rises 117 feet above ground level. Okay, like all the temples except Chaturbhuja Temple, Kandariya Mahadev faces east and is built upon a raised platform known as an Adisthana. Okay.
Ma'am, all the temples mostly face east.
Yes. Most of the time. Okay. Chaturbhuja Temple is also part of this Khajurao group of monuments. Okay. It faces west actually, Chaturbhuja Temple. Okay. The Kandariya Mahadev Temple, it is built upon a raised platform known as Adisthana, approached by a steep flight of steps. We'll see the image now. Okay. The architectural plan provides for a series of interconnected chambers approached by visitors in the following sequence. Okay. The inside of the temple is interconnected. Obviously, most of the times it is. Okay, the order is as such. Okay, a rectangular entrance hall, Ardha Mandapa, I'll just get the inbound here. A rectangular entrance hall, Ardha Mandapa, this one, okay, this one, Ardha Mandapa, leads from the steps, this is the steps, facing east, into a central pillared hall, Mandapa, okay. This leads to the darkened sanctuary, Garbhagriha, above which is the main tower and spire, okay. Inside the sanctuary is a marble devotional image, Linga, representing Shiva. This is a Shiva temple, as the name suggests, Mahadeva temple. Okay. The sanctum and Mandapa are encircled by an ambulatory. What is an ambulatory? Anybody?
I don't know, ma'am.
Ambulatory means a place of walking. Pradakshina. This you can see here, I think. Okay. It is surrounded by ambulatory where you do the pradakshina. Throughout the building, the architecture and the accompanying decorative art is deliberately symbolic and follows a standard pattern of Hindu iconography. Okay. The exterior structure of Kandariya Mahadev is based on a main tower, Shikhara. This is the Shikhara, the middle part, this part. Okay. The temple's highest point, it symbolizes Mount Kailash, which is Shiva's Himalayan mountain home. Okay, the main god. The main tower is surrounded by 84 smaller spires, as you can see, these. Can you guys see? Small, small spires are there. Okay, they are called Urushingas. We'll see the definitions of all these terms, okay? The whole building is made of sandstone with a granite foundation. Okay? No mortar was used in the temple's construction. The temples were connected with mortise and tenon joints. They are joints held in place by gravity. Okay, we have done what about studied about joints. You basically consider two stones, okay? One has a hole in it and one has a extending hole, and they both interconnect, okay? Because of gravity, they balance each other. It's a joint, so no mortar is used. The columns and architraves are composed of megaliths weighing up to 20 tons, okay? Up to 20 tons ka columns and architraves are there. What is a megalith? The word megalith means it is a large stone which is part of a, you can say, building, or in this case temple. Okay. So the entrance is base is Adhisthana, base platform. Then there's a steep flight of stairs. Then there's an Ardha Mandapa. Okay, then the Mandapa is there. And there is a Shikhara, which resembles Kailasha, which is the home of mountain home of Shiva. The main god is Linga. This sanctuary is darkened, okay? Most of the time, Garbhagriha is always dark, as far as I've seen, okay? The sanctum and Mandapa are covered by ambulatory Pradakshina Patha, okay? Throughout the building, architecture is very symbolic, as is in usual Hindu architecture, okay? Now we'll see what these mean, okay? Mandapa, these three which are there, Ardha Mandapa, Mandapa and Mahamandapa. Ardha Mandapa is the entrance porch. Okay, in olden times, these were used for when. No, I'll send this document to sir. This will be uploaded in the app. You can download it. Okay. So, mandapa was usually for people to sit around when they visit. You must have visited a Hindu temple. If you have, you know that every temple has a mandapa where people sit after visiting the god or when where they enter from where they enter. Adha mandapa is such entrance for. So mandapa generally means it is a pillared hall or pavilion for public rituals. Yes. Yeah, we'll do that. Pillared hall or pavilion for public rituals. Mandapas are described as open or closed depending on whether they have walls. This looks like the like open. Okay. Is someone saying something? I can't hear. For someone saying something, I can't hear it. I don't know what it is. You can put in chat. Okay, Jagati.
Someone's audio is on.
Achha, audio is on. Yeah, Jagati, here it is. Is there raised a surface of the platform or terrace upon which some Hindu or Buddhist temples are built? Okay, the base is a platform is Adisthana. Above that also there is a platform that's called a Jagati. Jagati is usually in temples which don't have walls. Okay. Next, you see Antarala. Okay. We saw mandapa. Most of the temples have one mandapa. They are small. Some of the bigger temples like this one have multiple. Okay, it depends on the architect, time when they were built. Now Antarala. Okay, Antarala comes between mandapa
Ma'am, in examination we need to write like. We need to write a three just we can write only mandapa is enough, huh, ma'am?
Yeah. Also, if they
we don't need to write maha mandapa and atta
mandapa. I said, generally mandapa is the only thing there. Specifications differ based on the temple. Also, if they're asking you three important architectural features, they will mostly they'll give you the plan. Okay, based on that you can see and write. Okay,
ma'am.
Antarala is the small antechamber or foyer between Garbhagriha, which is the main shrine, and mandapa, more typical of North Indian temples. Okay. I have seen Antaralas in South Indian temples also. Maybe they are there. Okay. So Antarala is a small antechamber or foyer. Okay. Between Garbhagriha and mandapa. So the main mandapa that is there, Mahamandapa here it is between Mahamandapa and the shrine is below the shikhar, right? Between them, there's the Antarala. They're not very big from what I've seen. They're small, they're usually small. Shikhara. Shikhara also called shikhar based on your dialect. In North Indian temple architecture is a superstructure, tower or spire above the sanctuary. Or Garbhagriha, and also above the pillared mandapas. Okay, this is the most dominant and characteristic feature of the Hindu temple in the north. Okay, here you can see from far. If you see, this is the most tallest part, and that is the most visible part. Okay. Now we have discussed this before, but I'll tell again. North Indian style temples, the tallest, I will say pillar, is called Shikhara. Okay? It is in the shape of not very angular shape. Okay? South Indian, it is pyramidal structure most of the time and it's called Vimana. Okay? Now, this is the Nagara architecture. North Indian architecture style is called Nagara architecture style. South Indian architecture style is called Dravid architecture style. there are few temples where both the styles are combined a bit. That's called Vesara architecture. Okay. Now here that we saw, there is an Amalaka. Okay. Right, Amalaka is there here, this part. Okay. What it means, we'll do. Amalaka is a segmented or notched stone disc, usually with ridges on the rim, that sits on the top of a Hindu temple's shikhar or main tower. Okay. I know it is a little difficult to get. I get an image. Okay, it's easier to understand. This is an Amalaka. Okay, as you can see. It is segmented or notched stone disc with ridges on the rim. Ridges means what?
Those things, ma'am.
These parts which are there, okay. It's a, you can say it is an extended part of the structure. On the rim of Sarani, that sits on the top of Hindu temple's shikhar or main tower. This is you found in the North Indian architecture style. Okay. North Indian temples that I've seen, actually even I've seen, most of them have steps. South Indian temples do, maybe they have less. Okay. Yeah. Instead of Amalaka as in North Indian architecture style, South Indians have capstone. Okay. This is another feature. We'll discuss that when we're discussing the South Indian temple. Karasa.
Ma'am, do you know what is sanctum?
Am I audible to you guys?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, do you know what is sanctum? S-A-N-C-T-U-M. S-A-N-C-T-U-M.
Sanctum. Garbhagriha is called sanctum.
Okay.
It is usually that sanctum word is used usually in churches. Our Indian temple architecture is called, Garbhagriha. Okay, Kalasa, the top part that you see here. Okay. Yeah. Kalasa or Kalasha is the pinnacle element in the form of a vase, pineal of a temple's tower, a cupola or pitcher. Okay. It is a top part, okay. It looks like a vase. Kalasa, I think you guys know the shape of it, okay. Is in Kannada they call it chomp. I don't want to call it other languages, okay. It's a typical, it's usually made of brass, from what I've seen. Okay. Next. Next is Urushingasi, subsidiary Shikharas. Okay. The main is Shikhara. There are smaller Shikharas. Okay. I can say. Urushinga is a Urushinga. Okay, I may pronounce it wrong also. It's a subsidiary tower pasted against the main tower, Shikhara in this case, in the Hindu temple architecture. The Urushinga is lower and narrower than the Shikhara. It strengthens the feeling of height given by temple. Okay. Just having the Shikhara as opposed to having subsidiary Shikharas, it adds to the feeling of height of the temple. It is always lower than the main tower, main Shikhara. Okay. Here there are many. Okay. But there may be just one or two also. The Mahadev temple has 84. Next, there is Garbhagriha, okay, Namalaka Shikhara, production as you see that. Parikrama or Pradakshina refers to circumambulation of sacred places to imbibe their energy in Sikh, Hindu, Jain or Buddhist context, and the path along this is the form is called the Pradakshina Patha. Okay. This pathway is made of stone around the shrine is called Pradakshina Patha. Okay. It is what is it? I can say that it is a circulation, may not be always circular, but to imbibe the energy of the god, the Garbhagriha, type of thing is in Sikh, Hindu, Jain and Buddhist religion, okay? And the path along which it is performed is called the Pradakshina Patha, okay? Yeah, I can say Mandapa Garbhagriha Shikhara. Mandapa Garbhagriha Shikhara, yes. Okay. Understood about Kandari Mahadeva temple? I repeat once more. Okay. It has Ardha Mandapa. Okay. It is the temple is based on Adhisthana base platform. Then comes the Jagrati. It is facing east. Okay. There are a steep flight of stairs. If you say the three important parts, that would be Mandapa, Garbhagriha and Shikhara. Okay. They ask more than but as you saw, it adds to the feeling of height. Okay. It may be structurally important too, but not the most important part. Okay. Yeah. So the steep flight of stairs leads to the Ardha Mandapa, which is the entrance porch. Then there's a hall, Mandapa. By the looks of it, both are open pavilions. Then there's the Mahamandapa, great hall. Okay, that from there you can go to the Antarala, because since all of these are interconnected, the interior of the temple is hollow throughout. Okay. Then it leads to the antarala, which is a vestibule. Then comes the shikara, the garbhagraha. That is the interior part. Now, outside if you see, not outside. Jagati is there. It's the platform on which the temple stands. Okay. Amalaka, the top part. Kailasha, which is the topmost part. Shikara is there. Okay. Garbhagraha has this garbhagraha has a linga, since it's a Shiva temple. Okay. There are not many temples which have statue of Shiva. There's a story there. Anyway, the inside part of the around the Garbhagraha, there is a circumambulation or production of Katha. Okay. Urushringa is there. Urushringa are subsidiary Shikhara, you can say. Okay. There are 84 Urushringas in this temple. Okay. They add to the feeling of height. You see the image, it looks very nice. See, the Shikhara is just this part. Okay. But these side may, as you can see, they are the Urushringa. They look add to the height. Okay. This is Mahamandapa, Ardha Mandapa. Sorry, Mahamandapa, Mandapa, and Ardha Mandapa. Entrance, flight of stairs. Okay, any doubt on this? Okay. I wanted to do some remaining parts of elements of design. Last class, I think we did pattern. Yeah, I think that. Patterns are simply a repetition of more than one design element. Okay, so the new students who weren't there before last class, we are doing elements of design. They what they have done is in the question paper they have asked questions like this. I'll show you. Which of the four terms or elements design describe the image given below. Okay, so hot and humid, rhythm, barren, distortion. In this case, these are some of the terms which they are asking, which of them associate with the image most. Okay, there may be more than four associating, but you have to name just four. Okay, understood this top question type?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. Okay, so till now we have done few emphasis, balance, radiation, contrast, white space, prism, beam. Okay, so we have done quite a few actually. This last one we did. Pattern means it's a simple, it's simply a repetition of one design element or one or more design elements working in concert with each other. They form a pattern element. Okay. A seamless pattern is one where every element within a design, no matter how often it's repeated, combines to form a whole. For example, this. Okay, it's actually a building, if I'm not wrong, a building facade. Okay, this element here. Cross, you can say. It is repeated over and over again. That forms a pattern. Okay. Here also. Okay. This is, I can say, fish type of word. Okay. It is repeated over and over again, forming a pattern. Your clothes, mostly churidars and all, they have a pattern. Okay. Radiation. Radiation is another way of achieving the rhythm in a design. Okay? Radiation occurs when lines or other elements extend outwards from a central point. It's another way of achieving rhythm. What is rhythm? Generally, if you have to say.
Something going in sync with each other.
Yes. Can you repeat it? Sorry, I
can't hear. Action of elements creates.
Okay. Rhythm, I can say in general, this one. It creates a sense of movement. Okay. So, this is another way of pattern of sound. Yes, rhythm generally true pattern of sound. If you take it in terms of art, architecture and views, then it means having a sense of movement. Focal point. Yes. Here, yes, there is a focal. No, focal point means what? Tell me. Focal point in a picture, suppose, in an image. Okay, suppose it's the take a typical example, image of Taj Mahal. Okay. What is a focal point on that?
The Taj Mahal.
Yes. The center part of the Taj Mahal. Okay. It gets our attention as something. Okay? That's the first part where our eye goes. Okay. Here, is there a part where our eye goes to one at one point? Just look at the image. Okay. Don't search for it, just see where your eye lands. Is there a point, focal point
in center?
In the center, okay. Okay,
so basically, whatever fixes your attention in one point, we can call it as a radiation, right?
No, it occurs when lines or other elements extend outwards. Okay, from a central point. This point may or may not be the focal point again. Okay.
Okay. Ma'am, but lines are compulsory, no? Like
lines are compulsory. It may not always be lines. Okay, I'll just wait, I'll see if I can find another image.
Ma'am, we can say a spiral is a radiation.
Yes. This is another example for variation. Okay, it shows rhythm, doesn't it? Just by seeing it, you can understand. Yes, it seems to be radiating. That is what it means, essentially. Next, tilt. An image or a block of text at an angle. Not a straight angle, obviously. Okay. Such images. There are. This is a beam. This tilting it gives it another straight is technically correct. Both are technically correct, but this looks more clean. Tilt is usually used in products. Crop. Technically, cropping means removal of unwanted outer areas from a photographic or illustrated image. Okay, but in art, it also means Removing a part of an element to add interest. Generally speaking, it is to add energy. Now, see, because of the cut off part, okay, the apple looks more interesting. If you see in any other illustrated image also, okay, that's interesting. It may be due to a reason also. Okay, depth. The apparent distance from front to back or near to far is an artwork. Okay. Techniques of perspective are used to create illusion of depth in paintings or drawings. Painting or drawings mein, it is 2D, correct? To show depth in that, they use a perspective, as they said. This image that you can see, depth, going through a tunnel. Okay, understood? If you have any doubt, please ask. Okay, linear perspective, a system of creating an illusion of depth on a flat surface. Okay. It is again connected to the depth part which is just now. All parallel lines or orthogonals in a painting or drawing using this system converge in a single vanishing point on the composition's horizon line. Okay. Reading this, what can you essentially say? It is one-point perspective, correct? They are saying all the lines, all lines, drawing or painting converge in a single point on the compositions. The parallel lines are supposed to be parallel. They are not supposed to converge anywhere. But from this perspective, to create an illusion of depth, the parallel lines, see here, tiles that are there, okay, these lines, okay, they converge at one point here, somewhere here, okay, to create an illusion of depth, showing that this is farther to the people standing. Okay? Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, some of the terms that they ask in your paper cannot be just strictly connected to art. They may be general terms also, for example. For example, parallelism. Okay. So, definition of parallel design. In a design in which individual stems means say block of wood, okay, or group of stems are placed in the same direction and are always the same distance apart from end to end. Okay. This is the example for parallelism in art. Okay. If this image is given and they ask whether there is parallelism in this artwork or image, yes, there is. Okay. Parallelism just doesn't always connect to strictly to art. It is a general term used in art in this case. Okay. I hope you guys understood what I'm meaning to say.
Yes, ma'am.
I will see an image actually, like an example. Yes, curved lines also can create parallelism. Elements of design describe the hot and humid, rhythm, barren, distortion, contrast, aerial, bland, gradation, hot and arid, evergreen, marsh. What about hot and humid? Does it match the image? What is hot and humid weather or climate?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
It does. Okay. Where do you find humid climate? What does humid mean?
The water
moisture.
Like water droplets.
Yes, there are water droplets in
moisture.
Right. Desert. Do